First, it was the telegraph, then the telephone, the cell phone, and now the next stage of telecommunications is one step closer to reality. Here with an update on AST SpaceMobile is MarketBeat analyst Jea Yu. Jea, it's been a really busy September for this company.
Yes, after 7 years and $1 billion later, they finally launched their first five BlueBird satellites into low Earth orbit. This is their Block 1 BlueBirds, and they're finally up in space. So anyone who had doubts that they would be able to get up in space, well, those doubts are proven wrong.
Yeah, we did a video on this one just a month or so ago, kind of going through what this company is. And really, their idea is to make sure that the whole world is connected, right? Talk a little bit more for those who missed that last video.
Sure. So AST SpaceMobile is trying to make the make drop calls a thing of the past. Normally, you have to be within a cell tower range in order for your cell phone service to stay steady and to not have drop calls. What AST SpaceMobile was doing is they are creating a space-based broadband cellular network that is going to be there to basically fill in all the gaps in between cell towers. In fact, it's like they're putting up 168 cell towers in space. And theoretically, you should be able to complete calls anywhere on the planet. And unlike satellite phones, you're not going to need any special equipment. Basically, any off-the-shelf smartphone will enable you to place a call anywhere in the world.
I think the other interesting thing that you wrote in your article about this is that right now, you know, as Americans, you might think most of the world is covered with cell phone coverage, but really this company is opening up an opportunity to reach more customers, right?
Absolutely. Basically, according to AST, they believe that there's $67 billion out there waiting for them by 2032. The reality is 42% of the global population doesn't have access to cellular service. They want to cash in on some of that, and they are teaming up with over 40 telecoms, mobile network providers to go ahead and basically have them provide this fill-in service. Who knows, they may even actually provide, you know, full service. AT&T and Verizon, the two biggest cell phone players in the U.S., they've come on board. They've come on board head first. AT&T has a 6-year deal with them. Verizon is basically spending $100 million in order to get their customers outfitted with this service. So the other thing to keep in mind is that now they are past the concept stage. They actually have the satellites, the first satellites in space. So a lot of these other memorandum of understanding potential contracts, partners, they can move forward because now it's no longer a concept, but they're actually getting closer to commercialization. And so I expect to see a lot of these MOUs actually turn into partnerships and real contracts.
Yeah, I think those partnerships are a huge part about this company's cash flow. Let's talk about that a little bit because they've spent a lot investing to get this infrastructure up. But now with these contracts, where do they stand with cash flow?
They have about $440 million in cash now. Each satellite costs about $30 million. The first Block 1, five satellites cost $150 million to basically manufacture and put up into space. Block 2 satellites, they probably cost less, but we're looking at 17 Block 2 satellites, which are actually 10 times more powerful than the Block 1 satellites. And those are looking to go up in 2025, with the first batch going up in first quarter 2025.
Now, the company made a major move right after launching its first five satellites. They announced a second stock option. Talk about what that's done.
Right. So actually, about 5 or 6 days before the September 12th launch, AST had put out an announcement basically stating that they were going to be doing a $400 million secondary offering. This is what's known as an at-the-market offering, which means that they can sell shares at the market up to $400 million. Now, that threw off a lot of investors, and the stock did take a tumble because they basically stated that they were not looking to raise any more cash through offerings in 2024. Now, the at-the-money offering actually has a three-year time limit. So they have up to 3 years to be able to raise the $400 million in cash by selling stock. So they could start doing that in 2025. But the notice basically says they can do it at any time moving forward.
Yeah, let's talk about all of the movement this stock has seen this month. You'd expect with a major launch that there'd be a lot of positive reaction in the stock to that news. But that paired with the new offering, there's been a lot of volatility for ASTS this month.
So the offering basically took the air kind of out of the stock. It fell down to the 25 area. And when they did launch on September 12th, the stock actually pulled back some, and then the day after is when the stock rallied back up into the 30s, but it has been slowly pulling back now, and that's mostly because, you know, they don't produce revenues yet, and you almost have a sell the news reaction that tends to happen when a significant event actually happens. So now we have to look forward to potential catalysts down the road.
Well, with all of the movement we've seen in the stock this month, is this a buy for investors right now, or is it still a pretty big risk?
Oh, yeah. This is a definite speculative stock. Like I said, they don't generate any revenues yet, but they're getting closer now to that commercialization stage. And according to AST, there's a potentially $67 billion out there by up to 2032 by filling in these connectivity gaps with the telephone carriers.
Well, we will continue to watch all of the moves and where this stock goes right here at MarketBeat. Thanks for the deep dive into the latest news for this company. And thank you for joining us here on MarketBeat. Stay tuned and subscribe for more market news. As always, happy investing.